everybody, and welcome to the Holiday Shootout, presented by the Ellie Productions Racing Network and 3M Innovation. Here we go. 13 cars will be rolling off here at Pennsylvania Speedway in Pennsylvania. A triangular-shaped track, a short track, actually. This is going to be a great race today. You will want to stick around to see it. As you've noticed, it will be nano-speed cars racing today. Nano-speed carnage, I should say. Now let's check out your top story today. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. takes the pole today with an incredibly fast run. You see him zip around that corner, and he took the pole. Matt Kenseth and Carl Edwards, they have a bit of a rivalry going on. It started in practice. They will be starting in the rear of the field because of this crash. Now for the most famous words in motorsports. Drivers, start your engines! As they fire them up and roll off, let's check out your starting lineup. On row 1, you'll find Ricky Stenhouse Jr. and Jimmy Johnson. Row 2, Tony Stewart and Greg Biffle. Row 3, Dale Earnhardt Jr. and Jeff Gordon. Row 4, you'll find Denny Hamlin and Ryan Newman. In row 5 is Casey Kane and Danica Patrick. Row 6, you'll find Kyle Busch along with Carl Edwards. And row 7 is Matt Kenseth. We'll be right back after this message. The Vonage Cup Series has reached its 5th season. Don't miss it on Evan DePaula's channel. Here are your EPRN picks to win it today. Greg Biffle is the first one, of course, sponsoring the race. He is always great at triangular tracks. Not as much as Jimmy Johnson, though. He has always been great at Pocono and Phoenix, but Ryan Newman had the best car in practice. Do not count him out of this race. Here are your track facts today. It's going to be 16-lap race, 13 cars. It's a 1.5-mile track. Passing in the turns is recommended. Watch for pit road traffic today. It's snowy, it's cold, but we are ready for great racing today. Here we go. Green flag is out in the way. We are green. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. leads him down here. Jimmy Johnson in second. Tony Stewart and Greg Biffle battle for third, and it looks like Stewart will be able to take that. Dale Earnhardt Jr. flies below Greg Biffle. Now a battle for third. And looks like Dale Earnhardt Jr. has won that battle. Look at Ricky Stenhouse coming around there. You see him start to single file, and there goes Tony Stewart for third. He'll take that spot. Oh, Carl Edwards gets spun! We told you about that rivalry. As Carl Edwards rule break for pit road, we go on board his teammate who's leading the race, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Carl Edwards had to break for pit road. There he is. Comes off here. And he tries to block Jimmy Johnson there, and Johnson breaks low. Oh, Ricky Stenhouse Jr., he could have gotten away, slipped away easily there. Jimmy Johnson all over the back bumper, the 17 car. Tony Stewart able to get around the 99 back there. A big battle for the lead, and oh, Newman hits the inside wall into Hamlin. Kane is involved. Caution is out. Caution's out here on lap 8. Oh my goodness, let's see a slow-mo replay. Ooh, it looks like Newman hit the inside wall, came up into Hamlin, who spun out right in front of Casey Kane. Denny Hamlin will be done for today. Here's some pit stops. And Matt Kenseth, I'm a little curious about that. What happened to him? He is on pit road with some damage. Let's take a look at what happened to Matt Kenseth. And it looks like contact with the 10 car right there. Oh man, that is not good. Well, we'll sort this out. We'll be right back after a word from our sponsor. The Reebok Cup Series has reached its 8th season. Go see JL Skavnicki's channel for more Reebok Cup Series. Here are some restart stories for today. The Lucky Dog Free Pass goes to Carl Edwards. He will be on the lead lap, and Matt Kenseth and Ryan Newman will restart one lap down. So here we go for the green flag on lap 10. We got 7 laps to go. Here we go. Green flag is out and away. And, oh, Johnson powerhouses. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. gets spun up into Jimmy Johnson. Tony Stewart fires away as Ricky Stenhouse Jr. breaks for pit road. Oh, my goodness. Wow. That was something there. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. just totally lost it. Jimmy Johnson tried to get around the outside, and five laps to go now, but Jimmy Johnson tried getting around the outside, and Stewart clinched into Stenhouse, and it spun him out. Now four laps to go. Can Dale Earnhardt Jr. catch up to Tony Stewart here? He has put quite a gap in between the two. Looks like Jr. is on a roll, man. He is fast. That car is fast. It's a lot faster than Stewart's car, at least, but he's still quite a bit back there, as you can see here. As they come around the turn, two laps to go here in the Holiday Shootout. Two laps of EPRN racing to go. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is two car lengths away from a victory, the final victory of this year in EPRN. Last lap. Here they come. Jr. pokes to the inside. Oh, Kyle Busch gets spun. Caution is out. Race is over. Oh, my goodness. That will end our race. Here's an instant replay. It looks like Newman clinched him again. Man, Newman has caused some real trouble today. That will end the race. It looks like, yeah. Actually, no. Kyle Busch came into the corner too fast and came right up in the Newman Stenhouse with nowhere to go. He's had a rough day. Now, who has won the final race this year of EPRN? And it is Tony Stewart! Tony Stewart wins the EPRN 3M Holiday Shootout. There's your Holiday Shootout winner, Tony Stewart. Congrats to him. Here's your finishing results. Tony Stewart takes the win. Dale Earnhardt Jr. with a good race today. And Ricky Stenhouse Jr. just really bad today. He was really good at the beginning, but just couldn't clinch it at the end. It has been a fantastic year of EPRN racing, and we thank you so much for all the support, and, you know, you guys are the absolute reason why I do this. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and we hope you enjoy the last little bit of 2014 we have left. One final time this year, this is LA Productions 49, signing out.